Bismillahi walhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back as we focus on the fifth verb with regards to frequency in the Qur'an as we seek to better connect to Allah Azza wa Jal through the Qur'an by better understanding. And so this fifth verb is ja'ala. Ja'ala. And Ibn Faris rahmatullahi alayhi, he says al-jeemu wal-aynu wal-lamu kalimatun ghayru munqasatin لا يشبه بعضها بعضا. So Ibn Faris rahmatullahi alayhi is telling us that this verb, these three letters, that they have different meanings and there's no real pattern in the way that he can make sense of or that's predictable. And so he gives us many different meanings here. He gives us five really, but the ones that are most important is number five, where he says, وَجَعَلْتُ شَيْئًا يَعْنِي صَنَعْتُهُ. That this fifth meaning, which is, I have done something. جَعَلَ is to have done something, but in this case it means to make. To make. صَنَعْتُهُ, I made this. So, جَعَلَ, he made. He made. The other meaning that is important is the fourth, which is al-ju'lu wal-ji'alatu aw al-ja'ila wa huwa ma yuj'alu lil-insani 'ala al-amri yaf'aluhu. That this fourth one is basically what is given as a reward or as a prize for whatever a person accomplishes of whatever they're tasked with. So you make a claim to say, whoever does this or if you do this, I'm going to give you that, I'll give you X. And so that X is what's called al-ju'lu aw al-ji'alatu aw al-ja'alatu aw al-ju'ala or al-ja'ila. But the most common of what we're looking at in the Quran is that fifth, which is in the meaning of he made. He made. And in the in Corpus Quran, we're told that this occurs 346 times, these three root letters. And 340 times out of them is ja'ala. Ja'ala. Allahu Azza wa Jalla is telling us how he made, subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever it is of the different things that he calls our attention. The other six times is in the form of the doer, al-fa'il, ja'ilu, ja'ilun. Ja'ilun being that he is the one, he is the maker. He is the maker, subhanahu. And so alhamdulillah, we have concluded the fifth verb. And hope that inshallah ta'ala, as you are reading the Qur'an and as you are now coming across these verbs, you'll better come to appreciate, because of understanding, what Allahu Rabbul Alameen is telling you. And in doing so, inshallah ta'ala, you'll feel a richer, deeper connection to Allahu Azza wa Jal through his speech to us. Allahumma ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.